And we welcome all of you to this session. And before we start our discussion this evening, let us pause for a moment to say a small prayer so that the Holy Spirit will guide and bless this endeavor. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. O Holy Spirit, cover all of us this evening as we share our experiences, as we discuss very important points about our family life together with our Mother Mary. May you inspire us this evening as we touch various aspects of family life, as Mother Mary becomes a role model. We also ask you to bless all the participants who have joined in through the Zoom. Bless them so that they will also be inspired through this sharing. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. So God bless you. This evening, we have a very touching and a very inspiring theme, which is Blessed Virgin Mary and the families. When I heard about this, when Manon called me and said, Father, would you be willing to come and do the discussion this evening with two lovely couples? I said, I would love to. And as soon as I said that, when I heard about the topic, the first thing that came to my mind was the Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary, which is also called the Litany of Loreto. And I'm sure you all recite that litany whenever you recite the Holy Rosary. And in that litany, we know it's a very traditional litany, handed down to us, through the history of the church. And, to that litany, to that traditional litany, seven petitions or seven invocations were added, in different stages of this litany. And only the popes have done it. So one such addition, one such new addition was Pope John Paul II added Mother of the Church. And for the second time, he again added Queen of the Families. And I thought this reflection is a beautiful one for our discussion today, to think about why Pope John Paul II added that new invocation, which is Queen of the Family. And if you take the litany and check, it appears in between Queen of the Most Holy Rosary and Queen of Peace in the litany that we recite at the end of the rosary. And I reflected, and I also read a little bit about why Pope John Paul II added this new invocation, which is, Mary, the Queen of our Families. And it just dawned on me then that she becomes the Queen of our Families simply because she is the Mother of the Church. So which means the second invocation naturally flows from the first invocation that our Pope added to the litany, which is the Mother of the Church. And reminding us of our families become the domestic church. In fact, the church refers to our families as the domestic church. So when she becomes the Mother of the Church, Pope realized that she inevitably becomes the Mother of our Families. And I stopped and thought about it for a while, which is very true. The Holy Mother, the Church, baptizes your children, administer the sacraments. But where do these faithful live? Where do these individuals flourish? They flourish within the very smallest unit, which is called the family. And when our Blessed Mother becomes the Mother of the Church, Pope realized that she, without any barrier, becomes the mother of this smallest unit in the church and in the society as well. So the family takes care of the children that the church welcomes through the sacrament of baptism. when the body and blood is shared, that child is kept safe in that family, and that nourishment is very well, you know, taken care of, you know, taken care of by the family. So therefore, it is very fitting that Pope John Paul II called our Blessed Mother the Queen of the Families. And I thought this evening, when I heard that two families are coming, I thought it would be beautiful for us to explain how she becomes the queen of our family. And Sanoj and Ranoj, I think you realized that she is indeed the mother of your family. But I think more than that, you realized, when I heard about your experience, you realized that she has become the mother of your, you know, family plus your personal life as well. First, you experienced that not as an adult. You experienced that while you were growing up, when you were schooling. And now I think your experience is way advanced. You know, you have experienced it in a very unique way now, because now that you are a family man. So I just would like to ask you, how was the experience, you know, when you got to know about our Blessed Mother, and how that faith and then how that devotion gradually developed in your life?
Thank you, Father Asita, for that question. Yes, as you correctly said, myself and Rukshi both happily accepted the invitation for this webinar when we got the call from Dr. Nilal about 3 or 4 weeks back. We happily accepted that. That is because as an individual, as a family man, we have loads of experience about our Holy Mother, about the Holy Queen, and we would love to share a few experiences. As you said, starting from the school life, I had a sir that who was teaching religion for us, and he was very strict. He was like following up all the students in our school, in our class, in our section, I would say, very strict on carrying the Holy Rosary. You know, it was a hassle. And as a young blood, we always tend to forget to bring the rosary to school and all these things. But when the time passed, when he was teaching us how important it is, the Holy Rosary, and where should we use the Holy Rosary, we were like getting used to it, and we were praying the Holy Rosary, reciting the Holy Rosary in the school hours, and we used to, it was not a, you know, and it was a habit to take. That habit, it became a habit to bring the Holy Rosary, bring the rosary with us, to carry the rosary with us, not only to the school, wherever we go. And of course, when we grow old, when we are adults, we have a good history. Myself and Rukshi's grandparents got married in St. Mary's Church, Bambalapitiya. And my parents got married in St. Mary's Church, Bambalapitiya. And finally, both of us got married in the same church. That is the history we have. And of course, we start our New Year journey by visiting the Holy Shrine of Matara, Mother Mary's Church, which we have experienced a lot. And we have got so much powerful messages through Mother Mary and through our loving God. And also, I would like to share one small experience, not a small experience, actually. As you said, we had so much of ups and downs in our lives when we started our marriage life. And we have a daughter, 8-year-old. So during these 8 years, she underwent about 6 surgeries, including 2 open heart surgeries. And the final, the second open heart surgery was a pretty serious case for us, both of us. Just before the surgery date, doctor came to our room, and he was explaining how serious will be the surgery. And as usual, we were shocked, and we didn't have anything. Only thing myself and Rukshi did was to handed over Diana to our Mother Mary, and we were reciting the Holy Rosary all throughout the night. And the time came for the surgery. It was around and that night doctor said, look here, there will be so much of complications. Until he opens, he cannot tell what exactly it is, and there will be complications. Diana will be in the ICU about 3 to 4 days. We will not be able to see her, all these things. And right after that day and the time came, 3 o'clock, we went to the theater. Rukshi gave Diana to the doctors and came out. Right after that, we were reciting the Holy Rosary. In fact, all our family members, I can remember some of our parishioners were with us, friends from our parish, Nayakanda Church, they were with us. And I can remember so many groups were praying. Through our connection, so many groups are praying to Diana. It was million rosaries we were praying. And doctor said it will be a 10-hour surgery, open heart surgery. And around 6 o'clock in the evening, doctor came out from the theater, and he just called both of us, and we went to the doctor, and doctor was saying, he confirmed Diana's surgery was a success, and all the complications that he was telling the other day, it's not there. So that was a miracle we saw from our Mother Mary, the Holy Queen, through our God. It was just one miracle, and I hope Rukshi will also share her experience. And so at this occasion, I would like to make a small request from the young couples who are going to get married, and as a Prikana couple, we used to tell this, just recite the Holy Rosary. If you can't recite the 5 decades, only one decade at least for the day, just recite the Holy Rosary. That will be a powerful message for y'all. And also throughout, after the marriage life, throughout, just continue praying, continue to do the family prayers, which will help to continue a good life. Always you will have answers through Mother Mary, through our loving God. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Ranaj. Rukshi, I know that this is not an easy journey. You know, when I heard about your story, your journey as a couple, as a very Catholic couple, I was really impressed. But I kind of thought of your journey in line with our Blessed Mother's journey. We know very well, when our Blessed Mother heard about this beautiful invitation calling that came from the angel to become the mother of Messiah, no, she must have been very happy, but it came with a cross. The cross was that, you know, she had to say yes to something that she didn't know or have full knowledge about. You know, the angel told our Blessed Mother she will be pregnant, and she'll be pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit, and that child is the Son of God. But then, you know, without counting the cost of it, she said yes. You know, maybe somebody can say that is the happy beginning of a beautiful journey, but it wasn't. From a human point of view, if you look at her story, the journey she had to go through with the Holy Family, it's very, very, from a human point of view, very, very disturbing. When she said yes, the biggest challenge was she was saying yes to become a husbandless mother, you know, and we know how difficult it is even now to bring up a child that has no father. But then God had a plan, and Saint Joseph was a very, very pious man, you know, also understood the will of God, the Almighty Father. But then even from there, the journey wasn't a smooth one. You know, they didn't have a place to, you know, give birth. And they had to take the child and go from here to there because the child's life was in danger. And even when the child grew up, there were certain things that they couldn't fathom and understand, you know. But our Blessed Mother, as the scripture says, she kept everything, you know, in her heart pondering, you know. But then even then, when Jesus grew up, when he entered into the public ministry, people couldn't understand Jesus and people thought that Jesus has lost it and probably came and complained to our Blessed Mother. As the scripture says, Blessed Mother went with the other brothers and sisters just to get him out, because the people must have complained to her. So she must have also gone through a lot of agony. As we say, she's also the mother of sorrows, so many sorrows, you know. But Rukshi, I think, is that the reason why you connect to our Blessed Mother very much? Why, as a wife, as a mother, as you have a daughter too, and is that the reason why you connect to our Blessed Mother? Because you can very well, you know, go and tell our Blessed Mother, because she understands. I would like to hear it from you, Rukshi.
Thank you, Father. And good evening, everyone. So 9 years ago, Father, I was expecting Diana. Diana is our first child and the only. And Imaraki, I'm sure that you can relate to this. Just like first love, a mother is excited and very enthusiastic about the first child when she's expecting for that. I'm not telling that they're not excited for the second, third, fourth, fifth, but the first child is always special in a family. So we were also very happy when the moment we got to know that I'm expecting, we were very happy. And all our family members, and being the only child of my family and the first child of ours being his family's first grandchild, we were very excited and we were so looking forward to it. And suddenly there was the news from the doctors saying that Rukshi, Ranuj, your daughter is going to have defects. And at that point, doctor said, you can decide whether you want to have the child or not. Well, we were shocked. And our whole world was shaken. And we were crying in the car park. And we had no place to go to. We went to St. Mary's Church, Dehivala, and again, St. Mary's Church, Dehivala. And it was only Holy Mother that we were calling to help us. We wanted her to come to our rescue because we really wanted her intercession to be there with us. And we prayed for her intercession. And we actually questioned God, why us? We didn't know what was going to happen. We didn't know, because the doctor said she will have defects, but we don't know the gravity. He didn't know the gravity of it. He just predicted, okay, she's going to have defects. We have to wait and see. We never know. So, yes, we prayed and prayed, because we knew that even Holy Mother, as you correctly said, Father, Holy Mother also said yes to an unknown future. She didn't know what was lying ahead of us. And the powerful message came to us, and we said yes to this child. And we said we are going to accept this child no matter what. We were very young. And not matured also. And we said yes. And we were happy making that decision. And from that day onwards, we were reciting the Holy Rosary. And we went to church every day, St. Mary's, Anilaya. And we were reciting the Holy Rosary. And I still remember when we were praying, Diana used to kick me. And when we stopped the prayer, she just calmly and quietly went to sleep, Imaraki. And it was a great experience we have. And 3rd of June, 2013. It's a very special day to us. That was the day Diana was born, our little princess. We didn't know it, whether it was a he or a she, and she was born. And in the theater, when I was taken into the theater, we decided to go for a C-section because we didn't want the child to suffer more. And we asked the doctors to go for a C-section. And when I was taken to the theater, I asked the nurses, Miss, is it all right? Because I knew that she had problems. And Miss, is it all right if I say Hail Mary? And I could bring the roof of the theater down because I was so loud. I was praying. And doctors were also like, okay. They didn't say anything. And I was praying and praying and praying. And the moment came. Diana was born, Diana came out, and they kept her on my chest. They were scared to keep her on my chest. They just took her away soon because they thought the readings will go up, the pressure, the temperature, everything will go up. So they didn't want to see that reaction from me. It was a miracle. Father, it was a, isn't it, Rano? Can you remember you were seated next to me and we were happy. We were happy because in that message, I always heard the voice of Mother Mary and Jesus, y'all are chosen. Y'all are chosen parents to be the parents of this child. That's why I'm giving this child to you. Y'all are chosen parents. And the journey was not easy, Father. As he said, she underwent 6 surgeries. And let me share one experience at the hospital when every other day we had to take her to the hospital to change the tubes because she was fed by a tube and we had to take her to the hospital. And one doctor, a lady doctor, came to me and asked, you knew that she had defects? And I said, before birth. Then I said, yes. And she asked me abruptly, why didn't you abort her? Then I looked at her and said, we are Catholics. We never do that.
So, Ruchi, yes, let me disturb you. When you knew that she was going to be born with complications, with, I mean, you know, she'll be a differently able child, somewhat. I'm sure you got recommendations from doctors, and as you said, as you very well said, you know, to abort the baby.
Yeah.
And you were very young. What prompted you? What prompted you with all this pressure and with people recommending you when, you know, people in the health sector recommending you that you should go for an abortion? What, I mean, Ranoch, this is for you as well, Rukshi. And what prompted you to keep the baby? Why were you so keen on keeping the baby? What gave you strength to keep this baby? Because, you know, there are so many abortions taking place today that, you know, that's very, very grave sin. That cries to heaven.
Yes.
So I would like you to share that because I'm sure there are other couples, you know, who would like to be also inspired, you know, would like to be inspired by hearing the same story. Because I know Blessed Mother and Saint Joseph, you know, took this child from God. You know, Blessed Mother was so keen on keeping the child. And Saint Joseph protected the child that was given by God. You know, if Saint Joseph messed up the plan, our Blessed Mother would have also ended up aborting the child. You know, you know, it's just, you know, presuming that.
Yeah.
So you went through that experience, you know, as a couple. Would you like to share that with us?
Yes, Father. What prompted us was the faith in God. We knew that God had a plan, and we always believe that God says, for sure, I know the plan I have for you, not for your harm, but for your welfare. Be patient and follow that journey. We always believed that, Father. We always believed that, and being inspired by your family members. They were always with us. They were always with us, holding us. I think it's a real blessing to have an immediate family like us, Father. They are always there with us. And with the faith we had in God and Mother Mary's intercession, and there was something burning in us. And that maybe that consciousness and the values that were instilled in us from day one, from our families, mothers, fathers, the grandparents. And we were strong in that decision. We never looked back. We knew that we will have so many challenges because it was an unknown. We actually didn't know what the challenges would be, but still, it was very difficult. Some rejected us. Some rejected our child and they said, oh, we are scared to look at your child. And still, we didn't want to give up on her. Something was there for them. Rano, do you have anything to add? What prompted us? Anything from you?
Yeah, I think it was the message that we got at the day one when we went to St. Mary's Church, Bambalapitiya. No, this is your plan. This baby is for y'all. That was the strong message we got from the Holy Queen, Mother Mary, and through the God. So I think that made us to keep that decision, a firm decision. And of course, as she said, as Rukshi said, our family members was really strong. And they were the pillars. They were right behind through this journey.
And I know, even though you had a very, very personal devotion to our Blessed Mother and the recitation of the Holy Rosary, but it wasn't always like that. You know, it was not, you were not always into prayer or reciting the rosary. And would you like to share why you had difficulties in pursuing this prayer life as a family?
Yes. Well, Father, yes, with the workload and with all the, I don't know, we lost it somewhere. I was going to share that experience also later. But as a family, when we are busy, I think especially at our age, we try to, we are involved in a lot of work and we want to do this, we want to do that, the child wants to do this and that, and we are busy with everything else, but not with prayer. And we miss that, I think, I'm not blaming, but with the commitments we have, but we didn't see it in our grandparents or our parents' lives. They also had things, but things, everything else keep us going, but we forget that prayer life. And well, recently, Father, my blood pressure skyrocketed. Then I couldn't sleep. I was anxious. I was scared. And I was calling Dr. Nilal also. And he was helping me out. I was actually suffering from anxiety. Anxiety illness disorder. I think I had something like that. My gosh, my heart was racing and so many issues I had. And when I looked up to God, what I felt was I was missing something. I was missing something and I knew that it was prayer. Well, of course, we were doing our individual prayers. We were individually praying. But as a family, we didn't pray for each other. As a family, we didn't get together because we were too busy. He was busy with his work. And after work, he was tired, exhausted. And after my classes, I'm tired. And Diana, Father, that Imaraki Diana, from the age of 1.5 years, Diana was keeping the rosary with her under the pillow. She never went to sleep. She was this size and this tall. And she never went to sleep without the rosary. That was really amusing to see this experience. And I should give credit to my mother-in-law, Mrs. Malkanti Panditaratna, for instilling that habit in her. Because I still remember how my grandmother trained me to pray and how she influenced me, inspired me. And grandparents have a major role in that scene, I would say. Because sometimes children will not listen to the parents, but the grandparents, they will listen to. And grandparents, and I'm sure you can relate to it, Ayanaka, and you can instill the habits in them and they will listen to you, isn't it? Yes. So his mother and my grandmother, I always give credit to them for training us and Diana to do that. And I'm glad that they did that. And Father, the other thing was I was away from God, and I realized the mother of the family, I was the mother of the family, and Mother Mary kept the family going. She always had the family together, and I think she was doing that leading role. And even at the cross, she was with Jesus. We never hear the news of, correct me if I'm wrong, Father, in the scriptures, we don't hear St. Joseph being there with Jesus at the cross. And
it's not mentioned in the
scriptures. It's not mentioned in the scriptures. And it was Holy Mother. And the mother was running the race. And I was missing that part, the prayer. I was away from God. Because of me, the whole family was away from God. And we had everything. We had everything. Name it, we had everything. But we didn't have that prayer life together. And we started praying. And our bond, and I was telling, I was a bad-tempered person, to be honest. I was a bad-tempered person. And by God, anxiousness, bad temper, everything coming together, I was a devil sometimes. And and when praying, everything settled down. And I'm so happy. And I was telling my mother also, is it okay if I tell it in Sinhala, Father? I call my mother Akka, and I fondly call her Akka, and she loves it. And I said, Akka, mata tarahayaneka hari naha wage neida poddan. I think it was because of prayers. Everything changed, Father. Everything changed. And we were blessed more. We were blessed more with that peacefulness in our family. And I'm so glad because of that. And lastly, Father, to add to my experiences, sometimes our own family reject us, judge us for our past mistakes, but we have a Holy Mother that we can always look up to. She will never, ever reject us. And this I call the power bank. This is my power bank. I always call this my power bank. Whenever I wake up at night, in the night, I touch the rosary, and I feel something. And I hear the voice. Breathe deeply. Breathe deeply. Go to sleep, my child. There is some power in it. This is really powerful. And this Holy Mother, sometimes I feel like she's cuddling me. And that warm embrace, I love it. And before I end, Father, I also have a small request to make. The first few years of marriage, it's not going to be easy. 24/7 living with the same person and a different kind, an unknown person. Gosh, it's going to be very difficult. And with prayer, you can do anything, achieve anything. And Holy Mother is always going to protect you. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Rukshi. Thank you. Thank you, Ranuj. And each time I think about our Blessed Mother's intervention, on behalf of our families, I go back to the beautiful story of the wedding feast at Cana. We have heard it. Sometimes many of us use it. I use it whenever I go for, weddings. I use that gospel passage to base my homily. It is there that our Blessed Mother shows how much of care she had for that couple during that wedding. Wine is something, luxurious, maybe, something that, we used to, get intoxicated. But for them, it was part of the culture. Wine was a sign of prosperity, and they were running out of wine, when the wedding lasted for about a week. And during the first couple of days, they were running out of wine. And Blessed Mother looked at this, innocent couple and must have thought, I need to go to my son and ask my son to help them. Because I don't want them to, feel ashamed as they begin their beautiful journey as a couple. And I think that's why our Blessed Mother is still looking after our families. That's how she becomes the queen of our families. She continued to intercede for all the families, especially for those families who are in trouble, who have issues, who are on the verge of, letting go of the other person. So our Blessed Mother still continued to intercede like a mother. And Imara, I think that is your experience as well. you know, and you and Neil, both of you have this beautiful experience how our Blessed Mother had been a mother to your family and mother to your children. And would you like to share that with us, Imara?
Yes, Father. Well, in my case, it comes from generations. From generations on, we have been shown how important it is to seek the help of Mother Mary. She is always there to intercede on our behalf. What inspired me most to hold Mother Mary close to my heart was my grandmother. My dear aunts used to relate the story about my grandmother. She had TB, and those days there was no cure, and she had a very short time to live. She knew that she was going to leave behind 5 children, the youngest being 3, and that was my father. I feel sad when I think of it also. And her mother, that's my great-grandmother, was very sad and worried about what really was going to happen to these 5 children. And those days, fathers didn't do anything. It was always the mother who was, mother was like a buffer. I mean, it takes in everything, all the knocks and whatever. So my grandmother knew that her mother was worried, and she said, mother, you don't have to worry. These children are not my children. These are God's children. And I have offered them to Mother Mary. So Mother Mary will continue to be their mother once I'm gone. What I would like to point out is, Father, now all these 5 turned out to be very God-fearing children. They were so kind and patient and always showed us so much love. They made very good families, all because of, I would say, because of Mother Mary's care and her intercession. Mother Mary intercedes on our behalf all the time. And Jesus would always honor her request, as you said, as in the wedding feast of Cana. Even though Jesus said, my time has not come yet, Mother Mary knew that he would not disregard her. And always as a generation, going down generations, we used to always venerate Mother Mary by reciting the rosary. And each time you recite the Hail Mary, you are asking Mother Mary from your heart to intercede on your behalf. So I am really grateful to my ancestors and my loved ones for keeping this flame of love for Mother Mary alive in our hearts. Actually, that was the legacy that they left behind for us. Now, Mother Mary's the character is, she is the authentic follower of God. She was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she was handed over to us as our mother by being the mother of God. And Jesus at the cross offered Mother Mary to us to be our mother. So from that time onwards, we treated her as our mother. Mothers, I would say, are more devoted to Mother Mary more than fathers.
Imar, I wanted to ask you that. I think all the mothers relate to our Blessed Mother, because they feel that, you know, the experience our Blessed Mother had, it is also the truth about, you know, their life as well. I'm sure that is why you can also experience, you know, her beautiful intercession in your life, because you feel that, you know, certain aspects of her life, you know, you can also relate to.
Yeah, so, because you can have a relationship with her, Father. So, and also we share the same role as a mother. Motherhood is a special gift from God. But at the same time, being a mother is not easy. As Rukshi said, she has gone through the mill, being a mother. We as mothers, we worry so much about the children, especially when you're taking care of the children. You face so many difficulties bringing them up at different stages of their life, from babyhood to adulthood. Still, we are worrying about them. My children are married and gone, and I have grandchildren, but I still worry about them. I have offered my grandchildren, but still, now with this new pandemic on, you tend to worry about all the time. Are they safe? You know, sometimes you're paranoid, I would say. But somehow you hand everything over to Mother Mary. And my older son had a deep devotion to Mother Mary. And one night he called us and said that Mother Mary was seated on the side of his bed. To me, I didn't take it lightly. I thought it was a dream. And I told him, it must have been a dream. And he said, no, definitely. He was seated exactly where you are seated now. And he insisted upon it. And the other day when he came, I was going to mention this at this webinar. So to make sure again, when he came, now he's 38 years old, I asked him, do you remember that incident? And he said, yes. Was it a dream? He said, no, definitely she was seated. So Father, my belief is that Mother Mary was and is truly in our midst. I know for sure that she is in my house. She's dwelling in my house. I feel it because for every twist and turn, I seek her help. So in raising these children up, I have always called out to her, Mother of Jesus, please be a mother to me and to my children. Well, even the simplest of prayers, I would say, Mother Mary hears it and she would answer prayers. Maybe it would take some time, but it is our belief that she is there for us all the time. Another incident is my first granddaughter. She is a gift from God through the intercession of Mary, Our Lady of Madhu. So in order to honor her, we named her after Mother Mary. And also I would like to mention another incident which may sound a bit trivial. For me, it is of great significance and an act of love where Mother Mary was concerned. I had to undergo an MRI scan. I was not nervous or anything. I just went in boldly. But once I was put into that capsule, I kind of panicked. I didn't want to develop a panic attack and cause problems to the radiologist. So I tried to keep calm, but I thought I wish my mother would be here with me. But suddenly I thought of Mother Mary and I called out to her and said, please hold me tight. And surely I felt that warm embrace. And I knew that Mother Mary was there with me and I was able to calm down. The love you have for Mother Mary, I would say, deepens the love you have for Jesus Christ. Because Mother Mary is here for all of us to, as a mother. We all share her as a mother. And she does not pick favorites. She does not reject anyone. So I encourage everyone to persevere in a relationship with Mother Mary and offer yourself and your loved ones to a warm, tender, loving care.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Imara. It is very true that our mother was given to us by Jesus himself. Jesus shared his mother with us so that whenever we need her maternal care and love, we can always turn to her and she will never despise. We'll never despise whenever we go with our needs and our wants to her. And I'm sure your wife bore witness to the fact that she has always, Mother, our Blessed Mother, had always been there all throughout your family experiences. And Anil, I would like to also hear from you, your experience as a father, how your devotion grew as a young man and as a husband and as a father towards our Blessed Mother.
Thank you, Father. First of all, Father, in our home, as we call it, the domestic church, Imara is the one who is center of our home. When you look at her devotion and her commitment to Mother Mary, it resonates through all of us, myself, my sons, my daughter-in-law, and my granddaughters. You know, my granddaughters come and spend time with us. Of course, lately, because of the pandemic, we haven't seen much of them. And Imara, with the two granddaughters, when they get to bed in the evening, they pray. They said they do pray the rosary, and they are extremely close. My two granddaughters are extremely close to Imara, and of course ourselves. And rosary becomes an absolute must with them. So, Father, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. As Mary is the mother of Christ, Christ is the head of the church, and Mary is the mother of the church. So, Mary has the power to intercede. Mary has the power to intercede with God. That's why we venerate Mother Mary and worship Jesus Christ. Looking at my own experience, yes, Rukshi did use the term power bank. That goes for me as well. In my younger days, I used to be very frightened of dreaming. And whatever the dreams were, I always had the rosary under my pillow. And that gave me a good night's sleep, and I was not afraid of dreams anymore. Even when I used in my higher studies, I used to never leave home. I used to live in Javata. In one pocket, I had my hanky because I was having keta, but the other pocket, I had the rosary with me. And the rosary has been a great strength to me. In my work life too, whenever I have to make a presentation, whenever I have to go for an important meeting, I always carry the rosary. It's a very, very powerful thing. And also, I would like to share one of our visits to the Shrine of Our Lady in Mathura. We went there during a time where there was a few issues, and we prayed, and we got the message that our home is, our four walls, our home is protected by Mother Mary. Nobody, no evil or nobody could influence our home. And Mother Mary takes a prominent position in our home, and Jesus Christ, who is the head of church and also is the head of our domestic church. So, in short, we do honor Mother Mary a lot. We love her. When there are issues, when there is solace, we look to her. Of course, I must say, my wife Imara is very pious. She goes for Mass every day, Novena. Well, I do go for Sunday Mass, and I'm not that pious. But she also keeps pushing me, saying, look, let's sell a decade of rosary. And with the kind of work that we do and with the kind of pressures that we have, sometimes, yes, we do forget to pray. But prayer is a must. And Mother Mary, through her intercession, and through her, we could reach our Lord Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father, who will no doubt will give us all what we want, but we must have faith, we must have trust, and we must have hope. Before I conclude, Father, I would like to just
I think, Anil, you have a beautiful story to conclude with. That shows... In fact, you know, that shows how much of love Blessed Mother has for us. She will never say no to us. whenever we go with our intentions to her. And she will always pray for us before our Heavenly Father. I think, you know, that will be a beautiful story that we can share with everyone to show how much of care she has for us.
So let me quote this, Father. One day, the blessed Lord was walking along the golden gates of heaven, and he noticed that there were some souls who had got into heaven very, very easily. So he went to Peter and said, Peter, I have given you the keys to heaven. You are to exercise the power wisely and judiciously. Tell me, Peter, how did these souls gain entry into my kingdom? Peter answered, Don't blame me, Lord. Every time I close the doors, your mother opens a window. So remember that there is always an open window for us, and we are her children. And through her intercession, we could always ask Jesus Christ for help. Thank you for one more little thing.
Go ahead, please.
And as her children, we say, Lovely lady dressed in blue, teach me how to pray. God was just your little boy, and he knows the way. Thank you, Father.
Thank you very much, Anil. Thank you very much, Imara. Thank you very much, Rukshi and Ranoj. And we at the very beginning, we had issues with little issues with technology. But all of us started praying rosary, you know, in our own way. Nobody, you know, said that we were praying, but we were praying. I saw from that end, you know, they were holding, you know, onto each other and praying the rosary. And we realized how much our Blessed Mother is close to us. But, you know, before we wind up, I want to ask from this young couple and also from our experienced couple, you know, we have something very, very disturbing today with regards to our families, which is the rate of the divorce cases that we have in our society today. And it is really, really alarming to see that we have more and more cases. And on the top of that, we have unfaithfulness, unforgiveness, and also impurity when it comes to family life. And also, we have already spoken about abortion. And when it comes to the faithfulness and also the purity, we have contraceptives that the church has always said no to. And we are always recommended natural family planning. And as couples who speak during pre-kinder classes, Rukshi, what do you think? Everybody thinks that, you know, the holiness that we see in our Blessed Mother's life, the purity that we see in our Blessed Mother's life, is not possible. That to live as a faithful couple, to live as a very pure couple is not possible. What would you like to share with our young couples? Maybe the couples who are struggling, the couples who think this is impossible, maybe they have given into sin and temptation and forgotten about that purity, faithfulness in their family life, which our Blessed Mother is always a role model for us. Would you like to share that with us?
Yes, Father, thank you very much for that question. And I would say it's possible because I try to have that purity throughout my marriage life. We've been able to do that. And the day I was getting married, what my grandmother told was, so if I put it in simple terms, Father, I hope it's okay. Never drink, if I go for like contraceptives in a simple way.
So don't use contraceptives.
Do natural planning. And that's a natural family planning is a must. Because your body is holy. Your body is holy. And of course, we are following Mother Mary and you need to be pure. And it has become something instant now to, you need a bit of discipline also in that, I would say. And we've been praying to Mother Mary, Father, because we actually had to plan. Because of Diana's complications, we had we actually had to do the planning well, and we didn't use, I have never used anything as such. So that was through prayer. That was through prayer, and I feel it. That was through prayer, and I feel it. And I have an alarm in my body. I think it's because of, it's through prayer that I get that alarm. I hear that alarm. It's not the time, and it's the time. And I follow that, and I adore that, and I adore that value as a woman who is in the mid-30s. I value that a lot, and I think this has blessed us a lot.
Thank you very much, Rukshi. Imar, if I may ask you, you are a mother, but you are also a grandmother, and you beautifully shared how our Blessed Mother has always inspired you. Would you like to say something to our young couples who are struggling to be faithful to one another, who consider divorce as the only option for their marriage? Would you like to say something to our couples?
Well, Father, when couples get into marriage, they say they love each other through thick and thin. But as time goes by, that kind of fades away. So all you got to do is keep hold of that love you have between the two, so that you will not go astray, I would say, in other words. Cling to each other, and so that you will be faithful to each other at that moment. Through Our Lady, through our, we're praying to Jesus, keep the sanctity of your marriage.
Thank you very much, Imara. So the beautiful experience that we share, the common experience that we share, is that our Blessed Mother's intervention has always been key in being faithful, in committing as faithful husbands and wives. And Holy Rosary binds us together as families. Not only that, as you said, it's a powerhouse, it's a power bank. And also it has become a weapon against the evil one, devil. So therefore, whenever we recite rosary, we feel that our Blessed Mother is covering us with her mantle, and her motherly love and motherly care always inspire us. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining, and may God bless you and God bless your families. Let's also pray that God will bless through this discussion today all the families who are struggling to be faithful, to stay committed to the beautiful life given to us, given to them by God. So thank you very much. Okay, God bless you.
Thank you, Father Asita, for that wonderful moderation. And thank you very much to the two beautiful couples, Rukshi, Ranoj, Imara, and Anil, for the powerful testimonies, the powerful messages, which were so inspiring. Before we conclude for the day, there is one small question, Father. The question is, what advice, Father, this is from Joy, what advice would you give young ones who question us, why would you go to God through Mother Mary? Jesus has given a direct path to get connected with God. Father, any further comments? Yes.
This is always the question we get, even about saints. Why don't we go to God directly rather than going to saints? Why can't we, or rather than going to our Blessed Mother, why can't we go directly to God? You know, we ask people to pray for us all the time. You know, if I have something going on, I will tell Rukshi, can you pray for me? Ranoj, can you pray for me? Mara, can you pray? Anil, can you pray for me? But we know, we believe the saints, they are in heaven, gazing at the face of our Heavenly Father. And we know that when we ask them to pray for us, that those prayers can be powerful. If I can ask you to pray and I believe in your prayers, when I know that there is someone who is in heaven can pray for me, why don't I do that? And this is very much, very important. I'm so sorry for saying this. Evangelicals throw this question at us all the time because they don't like saints. They don't like our Blessed Mother. And it's like throwing kerosene to a rattlesnake or something. You know, we believe that our Blessed Mother can take our prayers to God powerfully. And that's exactly what she did at the wedding feast of Cana. Took their intention to Jesus and said, Son, help them. They're in need. So therefore, we believe that our Blessed Mother will always take our prayers to God. We consider her as someone who will always pray for us before the throne of God. And Manon, I hope I answered your question.
Thank you, Father. Thank you very much. And as Father Iranga has put in the chat, Mother Mary said yes to an uncertain future. So we need to remember those words. So before wrapping up and coming to the final prayer, I would again like to thank Father Asita, our moderator tonight, and the two beautiful couples, Rukshi and Ranoj, Imara and Anil. And a big thank you also goes out to the webinar team of St. John Dal Bastoni Church Family Apostolate Committee, led by our parish priest, Reverend Dr. Father Anthony Funayandapulle. So thank you very much for joining. To all the participants, be on the lookout for our webinars every month on the last Saturday of the month. Next month, we will be having a webinar on Christian discipleship for families. So it's all around marriage enrichment topics. So that's it from me and the webinar team tonight. I will hand over back to Father Asita for the final prayer. Father, there is a request from one of the participants just to say one Hail Mary
and
to all the families in the world. Yes.
This is exactly what I was thinking as well. I don't want to pray any other prayer this evening. As we wind up our session, I want to pray the beautiful prayer, which is based on scripture. If I may say also, I want to pray the Hail Mary. And I invite all of you to join. Let's pray for every family that we know and that we don't know who are going through a tough time. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Thank you very much, and may God bless you.